Hello to all the people out there. Thank you so much for watching Medical and Nursing Knowledge Hub. Myself Pooja, and in continuation with the previous discussion only, today we will gonna see the vitamins. Yes, in previous discussion we have seen the fat soluble vitamins, and today we will be going to see the water soluble vitamins. Types, you already know they are broadly divided into two types, fat soluble or water soluble. And in water soluble they are further classified into non B complex vitamins or B complex vitamins. Some people may get confused whether vitamin C is water soluble or fat soluble. So we should be very clear in our mind, vitamin C is non B complex water soluble vitamin, and in B complex they are further divided like energy releasing or hematopoietic based on their function. In vitamin B complex they are ranging from vitamin B1 to vitamin B12. So first, what is the meaning of water soluble vitamins? These are soluble in aqueous solution or water, and they are used as a cofactor by many enzymes. Means there are so many metabolic reactions take place in our body, so they act as a coenzyme or cofactor for many enzymes. And the most important thing is they are not stored in our body, means they are excreted in urine, means we have to consume them regularly. First thing is vitamin C, that is another name of vitamin C is ascorbic acid. The main function of vitamin C is it is mainly required for synthesis and maturation of collagen. The main function of collagen is it acts as a supportive tissue for so many parts like skin, blood vessels and bone. It also provides immunity to us. It protects us from infection and mainly help in wound healing or cure of cuts. So if there is deficiency of vitamin C, then there will be disease known as scurvy, and the classical feature of scurvy is bleeding. But the question comes, the bleeding of which part? So it can lead to manifestation of bleeding in gums. Then subperiosteal bleeding can be there. Subperiosteal means around the bones or joints, and it can be manifested as pseudo paralysis in child. Means if then there will be joint and bone bleeding, and due to that child is not able to crawl or walk, so it will lead to frog like posture in that particular child. That the child is not having paralysis, but it will represent as a pseudo paralysis. Then it can lead to bleeding in perifollicular area. Perifollicular means around the hair. And deficiency can also lead to weakened connective tissue and slow in healing wounds and other cuts, and it will also lead to anemia. The resource for vitamin C is it is mainly found in plantain citrus fruits like gooseberries, blueberries, oranges, tomatoes, broccoli, red and green leafy vegetables. B complex vitamin, first is vitamin B1. It is mainly heat levi sulfur containing vitamin. It helps in our body to convert food into energy and aids in function of heart and our nervous system and immune system. And if there is deficiency, the deficiency commonly observed in population eating polished rice, and which will result in a disease known as beriberi. It can be of two types. It can be wet beriberi and it can be dry beriberi. In wet beriberi, there will be involvement of mainly cardiovascular system, and there will be presentation of edema in our different body part. And in dry beriberi, there will be involvement of mainly central nervous system, and it will lead to neuropathy of our body. Then in wet beriberi, as I already told, there will be involvement of cardiovascular system, and edema appeared in lower limb, trunk, face and other body cavities, and it will lead to abnormal blood pressure and weakening of heart. And in dry, it will lead to neuropathy, and person can become bedridden, and if not treated, it may lead to death also. And if deficiency of thiamine occur in children, then that deficiency is known as Wernicke's encephalopathy. And if the in a chronic alcoholic person, there will be gradually deficiency of thiamine, and that condition will also lead to Wernicke's encephalopathy. So it is also frequently asked question, which vitamin is deficient in chronic alcoholic person? So resources for vitamin B1 or thiamine is mainly the outer covering of food grains like rice, wheat and yeast. That's why it is mainly seen or commonly seen in a population eating polished rice. So there will be no coating or covering on their grains, and whole cereal, pulses, oil seeds and nuts. Then comes to the second vitamin B2, then another name is riboflavin. It is mainly required for our healthy growth and tissue repairs, and it also help in releasing energy from carbohydrate. If there is deficiency of riboflavin in human, then it will lead to recurrent oral ulcers and facial and ocular lesions. If Mainly, the symptoms will be ampullar stomatitis. Stomatitis means inflammation of oral cavity. Then chelosis. Chelosis means inflammation of our lips or cracking of lips. Glossitis, inflammation of tongue, and it will lead to magenta color due to deficiency of vitamin B2 or riboflavin. And it will lead to vascularization of cornea and the conjunctiva and blood shortage. Like there will be very dark red appearance of red eye. Then comes to the next vitamin, that is vitamin B3, another name is niacin. The deficiency mainly observed in a population taking maize-based diet and in person having Hartnut disease. Hartnut disease is basically a metabolic disorder in which there will be defective absorption of tryptophan. And we know tryptophan is an essential amino acid which is required for synthesis of niacin in our body. And it can also be seen in person having carcinoid syndrome. In this also there will be abnormal metabolism of tryptophan, and there will be in this the tryptophan converts into serotonin instead of converting into niacin, so there will be deficiency of niacin. And if there will be deficiency of niacin, it will lead to a disease known as Pleura. And the clinical manifestation of Pleura will be 4 days, very frequently asked question even in pediatrics and other competitive exams. Like 4 days, first thing is dermatitis, then diarrhea, dementia, death. Ultimately it can lead to death if not treated. And dermatitis will occur mainly in a sun exposed area, means where our skin is exposed to sun, mainly in neck region, that is Kessel's necklace. Kessel's necklace is also frequently asked question. Then the rich sources for vitamin B3 or niacin is, it mainly forms in meat, rice and whole grains. Then comes to the next, that is vitamin B5, the another name is pantothenic acid. It is required for formation of glycogen, fatty acids and steroid hormones, and its deficiency is rarely seen in human adults. Then comes to the next vitamin, that is vitamin B6, another name is pyridoxine, and it is required for healthy brain function, blood vessels formation, RBC formation and or protein metabolism, as well as for formation of various antibodies and our immune system. If there is deficiency of pyridoxine, then it will lead to peripheral neuropathy. There will be numbness and tingling sensation in our nerves and extremities, and that can also lead to refractory neonatal seizure. And yes, if there can be question like, if there is a child having problem of seizures and is not responding to the anticonvulsant drugs, what can be another reason? Then it can be due to deficiency of vitamin B6 or pyridoxine. And in peripheral neuropathy also occurring, person is on having treatment of antituberculosis drug, because isoniazid and ethambutol leads to pyridoxine deficiency and ultimately results into peripheral neuropathy. The sources which is having good amount of pyridoxines: meat, fish, liver, bananas, vegetables, cereals, corn and carrots, etc. Then comes to the next, that is vitamin B9, another name is folic acid. As you know, it is mainly required for synthesis of DNA and it prevents neural tube defect that mainly occur during fetal development. If there is deficiency of folic acid, then it will lead to megaloblastic anemia, mainly in pregnant women or unweaned children. Then resources is green leafy vegetable, whether it is spinach, cabbage, ladyfinger, mint leaves, pulses like black gram, green gram, etc. Then comes to the last vitamin, that is vitamin B12. Another name is cobalamin or cyanocobalamin. Vitamin B12 is important for metabolism and formation of red blood cells and maintenance of our central nervous system and spinal cord. If there is deficiency of vitamin B12, it will lead to pernicious anemia and nerve damage. These are also known as intrinsic factor. And its sources: eggs, meat, poultry, shellfish, milk. Daily value, daily requirement for various vitamins, as you can see on your projector. In summary, we have seen water-soluble vitamins ranging from B1 to B12 and vitamin C, their function, their deficiency and their sources. So if you like this video, give a big fat thumbs up and subscribe my channel so that whenever I post any video, you will be notified. And if you are having any doubt, you can post it in comment section. Till we meet, stay tuned. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.